So if you've been struggling to figure out how to get eye autofocus, whether you're recording in 4K or you're doing live streams in 4K, shout out to Walter Jennette for initially figuring out the portion when it comes to the live stream. We've been able to completely sort this out between some of the things that he found in his video and then me doing some testing there afterwards to figure out the other pieces. So thank you, Walter Jennette. We appreciate you. Let's dive into the video. So it'd be really great if we could have all of these settings on and literally have every setting that we want to use available. But unfortunately, the Sony cameras just don't work that way. So there are a couple rules when it comes to doing this in recording or doing this 4K. So let's do recording because that's a little bit simpler. So if you notice in the bottom left corner of the screen, you'll see that that autofocus box is disabled in the camera. What we need to do is go into the menu. And if you want to quickly get around, just hit that FN function button on your keys. And when you go down, of course, make sure you're in 4K, 24 or 30 frames per second, whatever you prefer. But when we're going in, a couple things that will make this be disabled, and that would be the proxy recording. And what this will do is simultaneously record 720p video files at the same time that you're doing your videos. If you're trying to edit and increase your workflow when you're doing Final Cut Pro or Adobe Premiere or somewhere thereabout. But if we simply turn this to off, go back to our main screen, then you'll see that this is enabled. So this takes care of this solution altogether, very, very simply. So that's all that you have to do is either decide if you want to have proxy recordings in the camera or maybe include that in your workflow afterwards and just have the, you know, Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut take care of that. So let's do the live streaming bit. So one of the clear signs that you don't have the 4K enabled is over here. You'll see that autofocus again is set to off, and we're back to our wide framing notified by those little tick marks there so that you're in the wide frame autofocus selection. You still have autofocus enabled, but it's just not face and eye available. A couple parts, this is going to be in two parts. The first one is before you connect your cable. You do want to make sure that you have PC remote function selected to off. And this is going to be on your network tab on this third tab in the first page here. And so once that's selected to off, then you're good from there. Now, when you go over to your HDMI settings, which are going to be over here in your little toolbox, I like to call it a briefcase, but it's neither here nor there. So HDMI settings, unfortunately, if you do tutorials similar to this where you like to capture that data and share that to your software, like I use Ecamm Live, that info display, it can be on or off, but it won't work either way. Unfortunately, also, this means that when we go over here to this other function, this 4K output select, that's going to be disabled until we connect our HDMI cable. So let's go ahead and do that. And then as soon as it is connected, you'll see that this now will turn to white and it will be available. Now, usually what this is set to in the camera is memory card as well as HDMI so that you record internally and live stream at the same time. If at any point where you're wanting to live stream and record, then you have to know that you're not gonna have access to eye autofocus as well as face detection autofocus. So you have to decide which one is more important when you're going through these selections. But once you have this available, over here you'll see where I have it selected to HDMI only and 24 since that's the frame rate that I'm using, but you need to select and match whatever it is that you have selected for your HDMI settings. So I'll pick 24 here. And then just to confirm that you have it set, you would need to do that before you connect so we can unplug really quickly. And we can see that that's at 24. I like to pick 2160, highest resolutions available, or 1080p, depending on what you're doing. But HDMI only is still set, so we'll still get our clean HDMI out. You go back out and we now have autofocus is enabled in 4K. So again, shout out to Walter Jennette. Thanks so much for your help in figuring out this. This was definitely something that plagued a lot of us and was super duper frustrating. If you want to get a quick cheat sheet downloadable for this so that you don't have to really remember all of this stuff, you can just check a cheat sheet guide. It'll be linked in the description for you to grab that. With that, guys, live with passion. I'll see you in the next video.